don't own me. I'm not just one of your many toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go with other boys.
The petticoat invasion began in 1918. 90 years ago, President Tyler brought women to the College of William & Mary, which had been made all male since inception in 1693. 224 years after the charter of the college, and 90 years after the welcoming of women into the community, the accomplishments of female students and alumni remain unacknowledged. Suzanne Matthews, an alumni from the college and a current Board of Visitors member, vividly remembers the social restrictions placed on women.
Presence of women at the college is still hidden even today. Current students cannot name any female alumni, save for Glenn Close or Sandra Day O'Connor, who isn't even an actual alumni.
No.
Lucy Elizabeth Berger.
Beth Comstock.
Elizabeth Mercer.
Jean Blackwell.
Lucy Ann Gilmer Taylor.
Christine Paradis.
Ethel Childress.
Penelope Kyle.
Ann Croxton.
Viola Baskerville.
Alice Trevitt.
Dr. Michelle Whitehurst Cook, our convocation speaker of the 2007-2008 school year. It's clear that the accomplishments of women, indeed even the presence of them, has been hidden and ignored since they first stepped onto campus. The presence of men is obvious from the positions of power and administration to the memorial dedicated to them around campus. In fact, there's not a single statue dedicated to women on campus save for the little girl playing in the flowers by the Crimdale. We intend to create a permanent memorial dedicated to the women who entered in the class of 1918 to stand alongside the men that are situated around our campus. Women, guided by their professor, decided to take action.
It's a beautiful celebration of 90 years of women at the College of William & Mary.
Just ain't no good if the sun shines in your skin.